What's going on, guys? I'm Antonio with the Business Download Clean Energy's EV Wrap-Up, and welcome back. EVs have gained a lot of attention in the past couple of years, but there are definitely still people trying to wrap their heads around the idea of them. Maybe it's because they're so new and there's lots of questions, but that's where I come in. On this special edition of the EV Wrap-Up, we're going to look at charging, but before we get started, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button below. So it's about that time. Let's get started. Question of the day is, how much power does it take to charge an EV? Well, obviously that depends on a few things like the type of vehicle, charger, power source, etc. To put it simply, it's very comparable to the amount of power that some of your household appliances need. Let me break it down for you. So electric vehicles have three charging options right now. There's a level one, level two, and there's DC fast charging. Level one is like plugging into a standard electrical AC outlet. It takes the least amount of energy at around 1500 watts. Be convenient for your home, but it definitely takes the longest to charge, offering about 5 miles of range per hour. A level two charger is faster. It'll draw about 7,200 watts, providing anywhere from 12 to 25 miles of range per hour. The range may seem a little wide, but that depends on the vehicle and its onboarding charger. What's an onboarding charger? Well, let's continue into the inception of questions. It basically converts the alternating current, or AC energy, into direct current, or DC energy. And I know how the 80s rock band got their name. Level 2 chargers are ideal for times you need to leave your car parked for at least an hour. So, you know, going to the mall, getting a nice dinner, maybe catching the latest Fast and Furious movie. Finally, there's DC fast charging. DC means direct current. Yay, we're learning. DC fast charging is like the fast pass at Disneyland. Pay a little more, but you get what you paid for. DC fast charging can deliver 100 miles of range per hour or more. Some EVs can even be charged at 80% in around 20 to 30 minutes. This would be ideal for your on-the-go charging, for some time to stretch your legs and maybe get a quick bite to eat. Once the U.S. infrastructure is fully up to speed and it's heading in that direction, these chargers will be found off freeways, at rest stops, and grocery stores, among other convenient locations. So now that we've explored different types of charging options, there are also different connectors we can examine. When I say connectors, I'm literally talking about the part that plugs in your vehicle's receptacle. The most common one in North America would be the J1772 connector, which looks like this. Most EVs use this one, but Tesla and a few other companies decided to be different and used alternative connectors, which opened the door to adapters, but we'll save that for another video. Most level 1 and 2 AC connectors use the J1772 plugins, but the DC fast charging receptacle usually has a removable piece that the DC connector can fit into. DC fast charging isn't meant to replace level 2 charging, it just provides a quicker option for longer trips. Level 2 charging is still the best choice for everyday charging and anytime you'll be parked for several hours, like overnight. But anyway, that's all we have for you on charging. If I answered any questions you may have had, or you still have more, please let me know in the comments. Be sure to like and subscribe. I hope you enjoyed it. We'll catch you soon.